Hello, my friends, how you doing today? You gotta live your life. Listen. Sometimes I get caught up in this, the various worlds of bullshit. And you're listening to Drive Time, by the way, watching Drive Time, episode 30B. It is a Monday. It's 12:34 in the p.m. lunchtime hour, Eastern Standard. Look, listen. Where was I talking about? Oh yeah, like the world of bullshit, the various worlds of bullshit, and the construct. I have various constructs which I exist in, right? And a big worry for me sometimes is that the constructs will... Wow, I just smelled something horrible. Something in my car, maybe. I hope it's not my car, so it's something outside. It's burnt rubber, but I didn't peel out or anything. It's got a horrible smell. So the constructs of them meeting up and how they match up together, and I worry about that sometimes, and I shouldn't. I should let it be. What will be, will be. And, everything that happens will be a direct result of my having let it happen, and I have to be okay with that. There's really no other alternative. Because there's not being okay with that, and it's a hypothetical moment I'm addressing. Really here, but I not being okay with that is just would cause too much internal panic and strife for me. So I gotta let that go, and I gotta just continue to, on one hand, just do what I do, what I'm doing. It's fine, and I gotta balance. I have to perfect the balance, and I have to, even within the balance, I have to do better. I have to do better on all counts. I don't know if that smell is still my car or not. This car, look, I'm coming for you live from inside of a 2000 Honda Accord. It's 2013 right now. We're pushing 176,000 miles. I don't drive this car a lot, so I thought I was gonna get to 200,000 miles no problem, easy, when I was driving a little more. But I really drive so little. I really only drive this car to and from work. You know, the 4 trips a day or whatever. The 4 trips back and forth. So it's really only 15 miles a day total. That's the whole thing. It's really not a, it's a very short drive. So I've been slowly putting on mileage, but it's been for some reason I just want to get 200,000 miles out of the car. I feel like it's been a good car, and I have not had to put much money into it over the years. So I can't complain. I take good care of it. Try to, basically take good care of it. And, it's a shitty car. It's at the point in the car's life where you don't. To me, at least, as not a car person, and who rarely is even in a car, I try to just think of it in terms of, well, it'll go its course, and when something really bad happens to it, I'll have to get worried about getting a new car, because it's really no point in like trying to put any money into, just let it out. It's like an old dog. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. I got some ideas. I gotta get the AA movie, the AA website done. That's a priority this week for me personally. This weekend, what I got going on, nothing much. slept pretty good last night for Sunday. I felt revived. And the run, man, I did a run. I talked about this on the previous episode, 30A. But I did a run yesterday that was just really a great run. And I'm very much wanting to do that again. Oh, another big point of emphasis is my eating habits. That has to improve. No excuse. That has to improve tenfold starting right now. And this lunch. No overeating. Because I overeat. And I'm not a fat man. But I'm not in the best, I'm not as trim as I could be. And I feel like I don't obsess over that, but it's definitely something that, you know, I would like to improve, and there's no reason not to improve. That's my thinking. And I definitely do I stress out eat and overeat, and I don't even like know I'm doing it. It's very odd. It's like I don't care. The thing about overeating is it's not like drinking and getting into trouble and really fucking your mind up and your day up and your body up. You overeat. Yes, you get fat and it's unhealthy in the long term, but it's such a slow long term killer that, you know, it's not like you don't feel the immediacy of it as you do with like a bad hangover or the consequences of bad over drinking results. Because you don't eat and you don't immediately put on weight the next day. You know, it doesn't work like that. And even if you overeat and your stomach hurts, it's not, you know, it's an uncomfortable feeling. And you're doing it because it's like you're looking for that release. It's like any kind of you're searching for that like kind of momentary high, and like in eating a lot of fucking carbs, for instance, satisfies that in some weird way. Even if you don't, I can't even describe why or what's going on. Sorry, I didn't talk for a second there. I was waiting to make a left-hand turn. I'm gonna go in today. I'm gonna eat my lunch. I got home a little earlier than I wanted to, but I definitely want to also. I definitely got home. God, why did I leave? I should have waited to time it out. I like to watch the beginning of Mike Francesa's show.